Hey there, welcome to Peer Yoga Studio in Stillwater, Minnesota. My name is Kay and I am here tonight, today I guess, to lead you through a 45 minute gentle yoga flow. So this is a class that you could do either in the morning when you wake up or before bed at night. We'll be connecting breath to movement. There won't be a lot of really strenuous moves, but you'll feel stretched out and hopefully just feel good after this class. So you don't need a lot of equipment to do yoga. That's one of the things that's really nice about it. It's good to have a mat if you've got one. However, if you don't have a mat, you can still do yoga. If you don't have a mat, I would recommend though that you find a couple of towels or blankets that you can roll up, because it's going to be nice to have a little extra padding to use under your knees and possibly under your wrists. Now you can do yoga on either a carpeted surface or on a hard floor. Just make sure that whatever surface you're on, you can stand on it safely without slipping. Okay, so that's probably the biggest safety concern, is to make sure that you're on a surface where you aren't going to slip. The only other safety concern with yoga is to make sure that you've got enough space around you. You want to make sure that when you're rotating your body, you're not going to bump something off of a table or a countertop, and that when you pick your leg up behind you, you're not going to kick a wall or a piece of furniture. So really, those are probably the only things to be the only safety concerns that you need to worry about. So for folks who are new to yoga, you may start thinking you're hearing a new language, and I totally understand that. So wherever you are, try to be in a place where you can actually see this video. Let's see. I will be calling this the top of my mat, and I will be calling this the bottom of my mat. Now, because of the orientation of the room and the way I'm set up, I will occasionally be flipping from end to end of the mat so that I'm not turning my back to you so much. But you shouldn't do that. So you should pick a top of your mat and a bottom of your mat and stay oriented top to bottom, okay? I will be cueing right and left. So instead of maybe looking at which direction I'm facing, just listen to my cues as far as whether you should be on your right or your left side. There'll be a few times when I'm facing you, sitting like this, and when I do that, when I cue right and left, just remember that I will not be mirroring you, and so I will be rotating the opposite way of you, and that's okay. If you ever get mixed up on side to side, that's okay. Just make it up on the next round doing the other side. So just think about balancing yourself out. It happens to everybody once in a while. So the only other thing I'd like to say before we start is to quote one of my very favorite ever yoga teachers. And he used to start every practice by reminding us that it was in fact yoga practice and not yoga perfect. And so he would always say that when you fall out of a pose or you stumble or you're shaking or you lose your balance, which we all do in yoga, to just keep reminding ourselves that, you know, we're here taking care of ourselves, and really we're just practicing to become a better version of who we are, and practicing to become a better yogi, if that's what your goal is. So let's get started. Actually, one more thing really quick, sorry about that. So if at any point during the practice you decide that you need to take a little break, there's just a couple things I'd recommend. One option is just to come into a cross-legged seated position or any position that's comfortable for you, and just close your eyes and take a couple breaths. Another posture that's a really nice resting posture if you need it is called Child's Pose. And in Child's Pose, you're gonna have your big toes touching in the back, your knees about the width of your mat apart, or your big toes touching behind, your knees about the width of the mat apart. You're gonna press your hips to the back. You can reach your arms overhead. You can bring them to your side. Whatever is comfortable for you, but this is another really nice resting pose. So again, if you need to take a break at any time during our practice today, please feel free to do that. I will be touching my phone once in a while during practice, and that's only because I'm playing with the music, adjusting the volume. So I'm gonna get the music started, make sure the volume is good. So we're going to start our practice today in a cross-legged seated position. I'm going to be facing you, but I would encourage you, if you can, if your device is up at the top of your mat, to rotate your body so that you're facing towards the top of your mat. And we'll start by closing our eyes pressing our hands on our knees. Palms down on your knees is a gesture of grounding. Palms up on your knees is a gesture of receiving. And we'll start by just doing some breathing. So we're going to breathe in through our nose as deeply as we possibly can, feeling our diaphragm pushing down into our lower belly, and then exhaling through an open mouth. Let's do that again. Big inhale, filling the lungs, feeling the diaphragm expanding, and an open mouth exhale. Two more times like that. Inhale. Continue breathing, but now using a closed mouth to warm your body. So in through your nose, and out through your nose. And as you continue your breathing, I want you to just try to let go of any thoughts that are invading your headspace. So forget about anything that happened today or is going to happen today. And if you're in your evening, forget about what happened today and all the things that you have to do tomorrow. I know we all have a lot going on right now. But I encourage you for the next 45 minutes to really try to clear your headspace and just focus on where you are in the moment, connecting your breath to motion, just using this time to reground and to recenter yourself. So let's just do a few more breaths in and out through our nose. Eyes, and we're going to start bringing some really gentle movements into our body. So I want you to take an inhale and just lean back slightly, and then an exhale, rotate forward. It doesn't matter if you're rotating clockwise or counterclockwise because we will switch directions. So inhale as you go back, exhale as you come forward. Inhale to move to the back, exhale coming forward. Let's do two more like this. Inhale coming exhale forward, and one last time, inhale back, and exhale forward. Now we're going to switch our direction. So we're going to start by inhale going back, exhale moving forward, inhale going back, exhale coming forward, inhale coming back, exhale forward. One more time, inhale as we go back, and exhale as we go forward. All right, let's start by now. Let's sit up nice and straight, and then take your right hand, put it behind your right hip. Inhale your left arm high, and on an exhale, take a twist to the right side of the room or whatever space you're in. So use your right arm, the arm that's behind you is sort of a second spine to help really lengthen that spine so that you're sitting up nice and straight. Let's take another inhale here, and on an exhale, turn back to the front of the room. Now this time, let's reach our left arm behind our left hip. Inhale our right arm high, and on an exhale, cross that right arm over the left knee, pressing gently into that left knee with the right hand to get some rotation to the left side. Sitting up nice and straight, using that left arm as a second spine to really hold your back straight with good length. Perfect. Let's come back to the front of the room. We're going to move now into a tabletop pose. So I'm going to switch so that my head is facing towards the top of the mat. So tabletop pose is just another way of saying hands and knees. So you're going to come onto your hands and knees on your mat, and again, this is where you're on a harder surface. You might want to place the towel or those towels or blankets on your hands or your knees. Just want you to check a few things. I want you to check that your hips are aligned over your knees, that your shoulders are aligned over your wrists, okay? I also don't want you pulling your shoulders up towards your ears. I want you to pull your shoulder blades down your back. And I want you to have a little bit lunge elbows. So index fingers pointing towards the front of the room, biceps rotating towards the front of the room, little flex in the elbow so that you're using your muscles rather than your joints to support your weight. Last of all, I want you to think about pulling your navel up to your spine, okay? So not letting your stomach sag, really pulling that navel up to activate your core. And we're gonna move through some cow and cat poses. So we're gonna inhale, let our belly drop, lift our tailbone and our chest high. Don't overstretch your neck, keep a neutral spine if you can. And then on an exhale, curve up the back, rolling it up towards the sky to find the cat pose. Let's inhale again, moving through cow. Exhale, moving through cat. Inhale, finding a nice flat back. I want you to stretch your right foot up behind you, pressing your right toe into the mat and pressing your heel to the back of the room. So when you do this, you're going to feel a nice stretch in that right calf. Again, think about pulling that core up nice and tight. Let's just stay here for about two or three breaths, allowing that left or right calf to stretch out. Inhale and lift that foot up off the mat, finding a straight line from the heel to the top of the head. If your hip is wanting to roll up like this, try to consciously bring it down to keep your hips level with the mat. So one more inhale, reaching that heel back towards the back of the room, and then an exhale, pull the knee to the nose. Let's inhale, stretching that heel back. Exhale, pulling the knee to the nose. So we're warming up our core here. Inhale, reaching that heel back. Exhale, knee to nose. One more time. Inhale, reach that heel back. And then land that knee on the mat. Let's switch sides. So press your right foot back. Right toes into the mat. Or sorry, left toes into the mat. Left heel pressing towards the back of the room. Stretching up that calf muscle. This is one of my favorite stretches. I love, love, love this one. Feels so good. Lifting that foot up off the mat, repeating what we did on the right side. Exhale, pulling knee to nose. Inhale, pressing the heel to the back of the room. Exhale, pulling knee to nose. Inhale, pressing the heel to the back of the room. Exhale, knee to nose. One more time. Inhale, pressing that heel to the back of the room. And exhale, knee to nose. Perfect, knee back down to the mat, trying to get this volume right. All right, we're gonna move now into a down dog. So in a down dog pose, I'm gonna have you move your hands a little more to the top of the mat. Again, index fingers still pointing toward the front of the room. You're gonna flip your toes towards the back of your mat and press your hips up nice and high. So you're finding really just an upside down V with your body. Now, depending on your level of flexibility, you may or may not be able to straighten your legs. If you have a bend in your knees, that is okay. Your heels don't need to reach the mat. In fact, for most of us, they won't and never ever will. So a couple things you can do to find some extra length in this down dog is you can lift up your heels and then shift your weight back. And when you do that, you'll find some extra length in your upper body. You can also lift up your heels, press your hips back, then drop your heels, and then lengthen your legs. And all those things will help you find some extra length in your down dog. We're going to stay here just for two more breaths. And then we're going to, on an inhale, look to the top of our mat, and on an exhale, walk our feet to the top of our mat. And we're going to move into a ragdoll pose. So feet should be about hip width apart. Forearms grab elbows,
And you're just going to hang, letting your head hang long, a relaxed neck. You should be looking between your knees when you do this. I encourage you to play around with a little bit. Maybe try bending your knees so that your chest actually makes contact with your thighs. And then lengthen. Maybe rock a little bit side to side if that feels good. So just take about two or three more breaths here, just sort of playing around with this pose. Now wherever you are, let go of your elbows, drop your hands to the mat. Place your left hand on the floor between your hands, so actually the up and front between your hands. And we're going to take a big inhale, and we're going to rotate our torso, lifting our right arm high. I know I'm not looking at you right now. Reaching, 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 looking up if that feels okay for your neck. If it doesn't, looking to the side or down is fine too. I would expect you probably have a little bit of bend in your knees, maybe a lot of bend in your knees, depending on your flexibility. All right, let's take another big inhale here, and on an exhale, drop our right hand to the mat, and in an inhale, let's lift the left arm high. You'll probably also notice that your knees shifted a little bit here. So when you were facing the other direction, your left knee shifted forward. And now probably you're feeling your right knee shift forward. That's okay and really pretty normal. All right, let's bring those hands to the mat one more time. Toe heel our feet in. Take one more big forward fold. And then on an inhale, let's roll up one spine at a time, sweeping our arms overhead. Exhale, bringing your hands to heart center. Closing your eyes for just a moment and honoring an intention for your practice today. And all that means is that you're going to focus on a thought or an idea, something that you're going to come back to during your practice. If your mind starts to wander to all the things that you need to do today, and if nothing else comes to mind, then consider gratitude. Gratitude for yourself for being here. Gratitude for your family, for your coworkers, for all the people that make your life wonderful. Sides of our body. And we're going to continue to warm up our bodies now, moving through a variation of Sun Salutation A, or Surya Namaskar A. So we're going to inhale our arms up overhead. Exhale, taking a forward fold, bringing your hands to heart center. Inhale, finding a halfway lift with a nice flat back. Exhale, bringing your hands back down to the mat. Inhale, stepping back to a high plank, first with your right foot, then with your left foot. Taking a breath here, inhale, exhale. Knees down is an option if you'd like. One more inhale, and on an exhale, pressing your hips high to find down dog. We'll take two breaths here in our down dog. Third inhale, look to the top of the mat, and on an exhale, walk your feet to the top. On an inhale, find a halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold again, maybe take a bend in your knees. Inhale, sweeping your arms up overhead. Exhale, finding goalpost or cactus arms, a little baby back bend, looking up if that feels good. Inhale, reaching your arms high, looking up if it feels good. Exhale, forward fold, hands come through heart center. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold, hands come to the mat. Inhale, step back to high plank, first with left foot, then with right foot. Again, if high plank is not in your practice right now, again, core pulled in, always we have our core pulled in yoga. Knees to the mat is an option. Two more breaths here in this high plank. So inhale,
inhale, and on an exhale, find your down dog. This time we'll just take one breath here. Inhale, look to the top of your mat. Exhale, feet to the top. Inhale, finding a halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold, hands to the mat. Inhale, sweeping those arms overhead. We're going to move into a gentle twist. So a little bend in the knee. Right arm sweeps to the back, left arm reaches forward. And we're taking a little twist here. Inhale, reaching those arms high. Exhale, twist the other way. Left arm to the back, right arm forward. Inhale, reaching those arms high. Exhale, forward fold, hands come to heart center. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, step back to high plank. First right, then left. Take a breath in. Take a breath out. One more inhale. Exhale, down dog. Breath in. Breath out. Inhale, looking to the top of your mat. Exhale, feet to the top. Inhale, finding that halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweeping your arms overhead. Moving into sun salutation, be your variation of it. Exhale, sinking into a chair pose, arms reach high. So in your chair pose, I want you to think about having your weight shifted back. So you ought to be able to wiggle your toes a little bit. And when you look down, you should actually be able to see your toes. So if you can, you're leaning too far forward, think about shifting your weight back. Let's take an inhale here. And on an exhale, bring your hands to our heart center. This is always an option if you don't like reaching overhead. One more inhale. And on an exhale, forward fold, hands come down to the mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, step back to plank, left, then right. Take a breath in and out. One more breath in. Exhale, down dog. This time you're going to inhale our right leg nice and high. And if you want, let the right heel fall towards the left hip, opening up that right hip joint for a breath or so. Then inhale, straightening out that leg, and on an exhale, bring it through, land it between your hands. Now, if it doesn't make it, grab it, help it, pull it through. The goal here is to try to set it up so that your knee is over your ankle. So if you're way back here, you need to think about getting that foot forward, aligning the knee up over the ankle. This is to protect your knee joint. You want about 45 degrees. Well, it doesn't have to be 45 degrees, but you want that aligned. I want you to flip your back foot around so that your left foot is making about a 45 degree angle with the back of your mat. You're going to engage your lower body, your quads, your glutes, and you're going to inhale, sweeping those arms up overhead, finding a warrior one pose. Taking a breath here, and on an exhale, bringing your hands back to the mat. Inhale, stepping back to high plank. Exhale, finding down dog. I'm going to inhale the left leg high this time, letting the left foot fall towards the right hip, opening up that hip joint. Then inhale, lifting that leg high. Exhale, bringing it through, landing it between your hands. Flipping that back foot to find a 45 degree angle, engaging all those muscles in the lower body and probably upper body too. Inhale, sweeping those arms high, find a warrior one. Exhale, hands come to the mat. Inhale, stepping back to high plank. Exhale, finding your down dog. Inhale, look to the top of your mat. Exhale, feet come to the top. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweeping your arms over high. Exhale, sinking back to find chair pose. Adding on. Inhale, take a breath. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Inhale, take another breath. Exhale, forward fold, hands to the mat. Inhale, halfway lift.
Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, step back to high plank, right then left. Inhale, take a breath. Exhale, down dog. All right, inhale your right leg high again. Exhale, step it through your hands, rotating that back foot. Inhale, bringing your arms high, find warrior one. Exhale, we're going to open to warrior two. So you're going to roll your hips so that you're pointing towards the left side of the room. Again, you want to check that your knee is tracking over your ankle. If your knee is rolling inward, consciously pull it back, all right? You can adjust the length of your stance to get this to feel how you need to. Back leg should be fairly straight. Outer edge of the foot pressing into the mat. Also, I don't want you leaning forward in this pose. I want you sitting up with your shoulders over your hips, reaching your arms long, torso, hips, all pointed to the left side. Take an inhale here. Take an exhale. Now, on an inhale, straighten that front leg. Reach the right arm high. We're finding a reverse triangle here. Big stretch on the right side of our body. And on an exhale, rotate, bringing your hands back to the mat, picking up that back heel. Inhale, stepping back to your high plank. Exhale, down dog on the left. So you're going to inhale the left leg high. Exhale, step between your hands, spinning that back foot. Stabilizing, checking that the knee is over the ankle. Inhaling those arms up, finding warrior one. Now I'm going to be turning my back to you. On an exhale, we're going to find warrior two, setting it up nice and strong. Shoulders over hips, knee tracking outward. Edge of the right foot pressing into the mat. Inhale, straightening that leg, reaching the left arm high, finding your reverse triangle. Big stretch on the left side of the body. Exhale, cartwheeling the hands down to the mat as that right heel lifts. Inhale, stepping back to high plank. Exhale, down dog. Let's take about two breaths here. Inhale, look to the top of your mat. Exhale, feet to the top. Continuing to add on. Inhale, finding a halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweeping those arms overhead. Exhale, find chair pose. Inhale. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Another inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step back, left foot and right, finding your high plank. Inhale, exhale, down dog. Inhale, the right leg high. Exhale, step it through, landing in between your hands, spinning that back foot. Inhaling those arms up to find warrior one. Exhale, opening arms. Finding warrior two. Inhale, straightening that front leg. Finding reverse triangle. Now keeping that front leg straight, I want you to lengthen your arms. Really check that your body is oriented towards the left side of the room. We're going to take an inhale and press our hips back, reach our arms forward as far as we can, and on an exhale, letting our right arm drop, reaching our left arm high, finding a triangle pose. Now you can do a triangle pose supporting your weight if you need to. You can use your thigh, you can use your quad or your shin, your ankle, or you can let that bottom arm float. The thing I don't want people to do is to collapse into this pose.
I want you to think about really being long and open. So this is an expansive opening pose. Again, where you look is up to you. You can look down towards your feet. You can look up towards your hand. It really doesn't matter. Let's take one more inhale. And then exhale. Now we're going to inhale. We're going to sweep that right arm up overhead. Spin our feet around and find star pose. You can see that right now my feet are roughly parallel to the edges of my mat. Take another big inhale here, and then exhale, find my hip creases, press my hips towards the back of the room, a little bend in my knee as I move into a wide-legged forward fold or Prasarita. I will stay here for a few breaths. You can take any variation of this that you want. I want you to think about really having your quads nice and tight though, so that your kneecaps are pulling upward. If you want, you can try reaching your arms back behind your mat, getting a little extra fold here. Hands up towards the edge of our mat, and then take an inhale, first of all, finding a nice flat back. And then on an exhale, forward fold, take a little bit of a bend in your knee, move your hands to your hip joints, your hip creases, and then articulate one spine at a time as you roll up on an inhale, sweeping those arms up overhead, finding your star pose. And I want you just to rotate your body towards the front of the room. So your front toes, your right toes are pointing towards the front of the room. Your left toes are at that 45 degree angle. And now I want you to think about leaning forward, again, pressing your hips to the back of the room, maybe making your hands down to your shin or your quad, and then folding to whatever level feels good here to you. This is a pyramid pose. Now, if you aren't feeling really flexible, this may be as far as you go. You can also adjust the amount of stretch you're feeling in your back hamstring by moving your left leg forward or back. So play around a little bit with this pose and find out what feels good. Knowing that what feels good on this side probably won't be the same as what feels good on the other side, because your body is very, very different. Start coming out of this pose, just walking our hand up our leg until we find some balance. Then let's inhale those arms up nice and high. Exhale, moving back into a warrior two. Inhale, reversing that warrior. Exhale, cartwheeling those hands down to the mat, stepping back to find a high plank. Taking a big inhale here, and then exhale. And then pressing back on an exhale to find your down dog. This time let's inhale a left leg high. And on an exhale, land it between your hands. Flipping that back foot, inhaling those arms up to find your warrior one. And I'm going to switch sides here so that I'm not bending over with my back to you. So you're in your warrior one. Your arms are reaching high. Exhale, we're going to move into our warrior two. And again, note, one side will probably feel very different than the other. On an inhale, we're going to find that reverse triangle, straightening that front leg. Take a breath here, enjoying the stretch on the left side of the body. Before reaching our arms nice and long, and checking that your body is rotated towards the right side. I guess it would be left side to you guys. I'm facing left, so you guys are facing right. We're gonna inhale, press our hips back, reach our arms forward, And then let that left arm drop, reaching the right arm high to find triangle pose. And again, think about really being open and expansive here, not collapsing into this pose. Just a couple breaths here. Before taking a little bend in that front knee and inhaling that left arm high to find star pose, rotating the feet so they're parallel to the edges of the mat. One more big inhale, reaching tall. Exhale, hands come to hip crease, forward fold, hands to the mat. Two breaths here. Inhale, finding a flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Little bend in the knees, hands come to the hip creases. Inhale, coming up to a standing pose, sweeping the arms overhead. Finding star pose. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. I know I did reverse warrior last time, but we're doing reverse triangle. And exhale, cartwheeling our hands to the mat, stepping back to that high plank. Inhale, exhale, down dog. So far, so good. Let's take a couple breaths here in our down dog and just pedal the feet out. Now that you're feeling warmer, you might actually be able to get your heels down a little bit lower than you could earlier in the practice. I'm going to come up on my toes, sink my hips, and then press everything back to really lengthen the upper part of my body as I take just a couple more breaths. Lunging type of poses. So I'm going to have you inhale your right leg high again. Exhale, sweep it through, landing in between your hands. And then let your back knee drop down to the mat. All right, I'm going to be turning away from you here, but I think you should still be able to see what I'm doing now. Where are you? So back knee down to the mat. It could be here at a 45 degree, right? So I've got like a 45 degree bend. 45 degree bend here. Back knee down could also be stretched back here. If you want to feel a little more stretch right here in your left hip flexor. We're actually going to go into a twisted lunge here. So I'm going to have you inhale your arms up high. Make sure you're really engaging through that lower body and core. And on an exhale, bring your hands through first to your heart center, sitting up nice and straight. And then you're going to rotate towards the right, trying, if you can, to get your right elbow across to the other side of your right knee. And then you're going to really press those hands together to twist your torso so that you're in a prayer twist, but in a lunging position. I always feel pretty wobbly in this. But if you want to try a little something extra, what you can do here is you can flip that back toe and try bringing up that back knee. This is just an option, it's not a requirement. We'll stay here for two more breaths. If your knee is up, gently land that knee. Come out of that twist. Bring your hands down to the mat, toe heel, your right foot towards the right edge of your mat, and we're going to move into a runner's lunge. So your runner's lunge might be right here. This might be as much as you do for a runner's lunge.
if you have a bit more flexibility, consider actually trying to come down a little bit lower. Possibly, if you're feeling really flexible, you can get your forearms down. Now, sometimes I can do this and sometimes I can't. And it's always a lot harder on my right side than on my left. So this is my harder side. Take a couple breaths here, opening up this hip. Heel that foot in wherever you are, pop up that back knee, and on an inhale, step back to that high plank, and on an exhale, move back your down dog to that on the other side. So inhale the left leg high, exhale, land it between your hands, let your right knee come down to the mat. Inhale, sweeping the arms up overhead, engaging the lower body, exhale, bringing hands to heart center. And this time rotating towards the left elbow crosses, or right elbow crosses over the left knee, pressing those hands together to really open your chest and rotate. And if you'd like, whoopsie, here's a fall. It happens to everybody. We're gonna press up out of that leg. There we go, that's better. Yoga practice. Balance is a lot shakier on this side. So let's hold this for another 2 breaths. Then drop that knee back down to the mat. Bring your hands down to the mat. Toe heel the left foot out towards the left edge of the mat. And so you can do that runner's lunge. Lunge, bringing that foot back to the center, popping up that back knee. Inhale, stepping back to a high plank, and exhale, moving back one more time to find a down dog. Now, it wouldn't be a yoga class without a little balance work, so we're going to do a couple of standing balance poses. So let's inhale, looking to the top of our mat, exhale, walk our feet to the top. And on an inhale, let's sweep our arms up overhead. Exhale, bring hands to heart center. Now I'm going to turn towards you, which means I'm going to be doing the opposite side of you for the balancing poses. So we're going to start by shifting all our weight to our left side. As I mentioned earlier, this is my bad balance side, so I will probably fall out of these. And we're going to move into a tree pose. So three possibilities for tree pose. One is to use a kickstand, so your toes remain on the mat. You can also bring your foot to the inside of your shin or above your knee to the inside of your thigh. Now you'll notice I'm not looking at you. I'm looking at the floor in front of me. That's because that's how I get the best balance. I'm looking at something that's not moving. And if you were looking at me, you will see that I am wobbling a lot here. So we're going to stay here for another breath. And then I want you to try to use control, and wherever you are, peel that foot up off the knee or the floor or the shin, or I shouldn't say the knee, the shin or the thigh, and move into a parallel tree. So your thigh is parallel with the floor. Now reach your right hand to the inside of your right knee, and as you pull that knee open,
reach that left arm long. For three, two, one, and done. Ooh, you did it. All right. Let's try that on the other side. Weight shifts to the right leg. Right or left foot comes to the shin, not the knee. You can kickstand or you can bring it up to your inner thigh. Hands come to heart center. Again, find stability by finding a place on the floor in front of you that is not moving. Wobbling is okay. Falling out is okay. Alright, using control, peel that foot off your leg and see if you can bring that knee up, that thigh up towards parallel to the floor. Reaching your left hand on the inside of your left knee, reaching your right arm long, opening that knee up, opening that knee to the side, and landing that on the floor. Nice work, good job. So the good news is you've made it through all the hard stuff. So we're just now going to make our way down to the floor and work through some things to start cooling our bodies down. All right. So I'm going to have you start by coming down to your back. Pulling your heels in up towards your hips, and we're going to just do just a couple of bridges here just to kind of stretch out that lower body. So pressing your hands into the mat, I want you just to lift your hips up off the mat, take a breath in, take a belated breath out, one more breath in, and then an exhale, lower down to the mat. Bring your knees in. Let's rock side to side a couple times. Let's do that again. Let's bring our heels to the mat. Pressing our heels downward, kind of pulling up towards our bottom side, then pressing downward, lifting our hips high. Everything come down to the mat, pulling those knees and rocking back and forth. We're going to move into a little bit of hip opening here. So place your left foot on the mat, cross your right knee or your right ankle over your left knee. Now, depending on your level of flexibility, all you may want to do here is just really gently press on this knee. And you'll feel some stretching and opening in the right hip joint. If you have more flexibility, you can pull that foot off the mat, reach behind that left leg, and actually pull that left leg towards you while you use your right elbow to actually press the right knee away. Left knee or the left ankle over the right knee, pressing the left elbow into the left knee, pulling everything towards you, stretching out the left hip joint this time. Thank you. across those knees, pull our knees in towards our chest, or across the legs, pull our knees in towards our chest, or our back, just a couple times. We're gonna move into a really nice inversion here, legs up the wall. So I want you just to lay on your back, lift your legs high, flex your feet, pulling your toes towards your chest, and we'll just stay here for a few breaths. Inversions are usually one of my very favorite parts of any class. I love how this feels. It's like I can feel all the fluids like just draining out of my legs. It's such a nice feeling. Take three more breaths here. Alright, get your heels strapped on the mat. Bring them sort of so they're about the width of your mat apart. Maybe reach your arms out a little further to the side. Just windshield wiper your legs side to side a couple times. Ending with your legs over towards the left side. And then look maybe to the right if that feels good. And also consider the possibility of just picking up your right leg and moving it a little further over your left. So you're going to find a big stretch again along the right side of your body here. Optional is to goalpost your arms or to grab that right leg and maybe pull it up a little higher. Let's bring both our feet back to the mat and do a windshield wiper in each direction, first to the right and then to the left. And now this time let your legs fall to the right side if you want. Bring that left leg over a little higher. Look towards the left if that feels good for your head. And again, like a lot of the other poses we've done today, you'll probably find but this feels really different on each side of your body. One side feels a lot more flexible than the other. Let's bring everything back to the center. One more stretch. So lengthen your left leg. So your left leg, I should say, either can be bent or long. It's up to you. Let's grab behind that right shin. Bend in the knee or not. And just really gently pull that leg in towards your chest. We're just stretching the hamstring a little bit on the right side. And if you want, you can pull your torso towards that leg as well. Switch sides, so right knee bent or leg extended, straightening the left leg as much as is comfortable and pulling it in. Now I am a lot tighter on my left side because I have a hamstring injury right now on the left, so I have to be a lot more careful on this side. You finish that stretch. to switch up our music right now, because this is a good place to do it. So let's take one more time. So release your left leg. Let's just take one more time rock and rolling on our back. And we're going to move now into Shavasana. And we're just going to do a really pretty short Shavasana, just a couple of minutes. So I want you to find a position that's comfortable for you. You can be on your back, you can be on your side. If neither of those work for you, you can also just sit up in an upright position. But wherever you are, I want you to find some stillness. And just again, focus on your breathing. Letting go of, again, everything that's happened today or will happen today or tomorrow. Coming into the moment, into the present. Returning to your intention if you set one for the practice. And if you didn't set one, maybe come back to gratitude. Gratitude that you're here, gratitude that you made it. Gratitude for all the people around you, virtually, but still here. Gratitude to your body. Start to reawaken our bodies first by taking a couple of really deep breaths in through our nose and out through our nose. And then bringing a little movement back into our ankles and wrists. I like to take a full body stretch on a big inhale. And then pull my knees in. Rock back and forth a couple times on the low back. And then flip over to one side or the other using your forearm for a pillow. Take a couple breaths. And then press yourself back up to a seated position. Legs crossed in front of you or in any seated position that's comfortable for you. Let's bring our hands together in front of our chest and then bring them up to our foreheads. May you have peace in your thoughts. Bring them down to your lips. May teacher in me honors the light and the teacher.